On edge finding, we want to set our spindle speed to around 800 RPM. The goal when we edge find is to get the center of our spindle directly over the edge of our part. The diameter of this edge finder is 0.2, so when we do find the edge, the center of the spindle will still be 0.1 away from the edge. You'll also notice on the edge finder it's undercut here. The reason for the undercut is when you bring it up to your edge, you'd like the very edge of the part where there might be a burr to come in on the undercut. So we don't find the edge of the burr, but we find the edge of our part. So we'll start our spindle, should be running 600 to 800 RPM. Make sure the edge finder is running out. And as we move over, we begin to touch the edge of our part. You'll notice the edge finder run truer and truer and truer. We're going to keep moving the edge finder over. Eventually, it'll look like it's running perfect. And then it'll make a small jump that'll be very noticeable. Okay, there's our jump. Once we have our jump, we're now 1/100 thou away from our edge. So we found our edge of our part. We can now set our digital readout to read 0 on the appropriate axis. The easiest way that doesn't confuse most people is to set the X to 0.1 and then move this table over another 1/100 thou and visually check that you're still, by eye, the center of the spindle is over the edge of the part and you haven't moved the 1/100 thou in the wrong direction. After we move the 1/100 thou, again, we can visually check by eye, center of our spindle is over the edge of the part and we've moved it 1/100 thou in the proper direction. Reset the digital readout to 0 and we've now found our X axis 0. We can repeat again for on the Y. When you need to be more than 2/1/2 accuracy of finding the exact edge of your part in relation to the center of the spindle, you can use an indicator. So set this indicator up by eye, the edge of the part, so that when you rotate it around by eye, it looks like that edge of the ball will be on the edge of the part. We now need to lower the spindle so that the indicator is touching the edge. Find your high spot. Set the indicator to 0. Double check when you rotate it back and forth you found the high spot. Rotate the spindle 180 degrees. You can use a mirror or you can just look at the spindle from the outside against the outside of your part. And again, rotate the spindle to the high spot. In this case, we can see we're out 0.5 thou off the exact edge. 0.5 thou is typically not worth bothering with. If we are out 0.1 thou, we can then adjust our x-axis until the indicator reads the same on both sides of the part and we've found the exact center